This is, I thought we'd just get straight into this. This is my first tutorial on Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2014. So, we're going to start by importing media. And this is going to be a very simple tutorial. Where we're going to put in things in here. So we're going to import some clips. Sorry if you can hear me eating. I'm eating right now. Anyway. We're going to put a couple of clips together. This is going to be a short tutorial. Actually, it's some footage that's not very good quality. And give it a good look. Yes, that's my audio. So yeah, that's my audio. So we have a couple of clips here, including this one. So what we're going to do with it is we're going to import it. Let's move it in by pasting and dropping it like that, dragging just the video in. And of course now we've got simple video. I'm going to add that in with this clip here, very artistic-y looking clip. Put that in the context. Let's watch it over. We got this simple transition coming through, but there's still no professionalness in there. Where are we going to get the professionalness? Well, we're about to add something. There's this random clip here that I thought I might add, which is very simple but very different. So we'll put those in. Now you got this sort of very artistic looking video clip. Yeah, so this is the footage I just sorted out. So now we got that in, but what are we going to do for sound itself? Well, sorry about that. Well, there you go then. So what we're going to do is we need to add something to give it that sort of look, you know, that sort of anamorphic. So we're going to choose 2.75 ultra panavision. So we're just going to put that directly on top. Now, if you're wondering how you do this with these Photoshop creations, or the ones you've installed that are originally probably Photoshop files, go around over them and click scale to frame size. Not scale, or set to frame size. But usually scale to frame size works best, and then go into uniform and it'll automatically stretch. But if you want to edit it even more, you can change the size, but I leave it like that. So I know exactly what file it's going to be exact, so I know it's not going to be rough ready. So yeah, there it is. Very roughly made, but there you got it. Now, what we're going to do is, this is exactly how I make my films. Now, some people might baffle on and say this is the wrong way to do filming. There's many ways to do filmmaking. It's just the way you do it. I'm sorry if you keep hearing messages. I really need to turn my notifications up. Give me 1 minute. Sorry about that, folks. So, yeah. So, we got ourselves some sort of clip. So, yeah. I'm thinking, this is working. Yeah, this is working. Yeah, I think this is working quite well. Yeah. So, yeah. Right. Now, we've got ourselves a sort of look, but we need to worry about the other part, which is the colour grading and the lumetri effects and many other stuff. Now the best thing to do is to give it the look I want. Before I do any of that jazz, I'm going to go and add some music. So we're going to choose one of my stock royalty free music. We're going to choose one of these. I'm just going to use this one. It's quite a good theme tune. See if I can hear it. Yeah, that works. It's gonna take it from the beginning. What about that? Now, what I'm gonna do is import that in. Just drag this the music in, file in, put it, drop at the bottom, cut it down to there, go into the effects. Audio transitions, exponential fade. And I'm going to set that to 5. Now that should do it. Now we've got some music in our hands. Let's see what that looks like. Now we need to edit something on there, so we're just going to hover over here. Cut it down about there. Drag it along. I'll also extend that, and I'll turn that to 5, yeah, it's already set as 5. Right, that should be better. I'm saving up for a big TV, you see, and when I get that big TV, hopefully a laptop this year. So basically, when I get a laptop, I'm going to continue doing, maybe doing videos on there, but I'm also going to use, a big screen hooked up. So basically, when I get a laptop, eventually when I finally get a big TV I'm trying to get, I'm going to hook up a wire from my laptop to there to use that as a second screen, so that I will have the film twice over. I have a massive version on my main screen, so I can see what's going to look like on the final thing. But obviously I don't have that yet, so I can't go that far. I don't use a very professional camera, not this time, but I'm working on it. People say that you need at least a DSLR for a cinematic effect, but here I'll give you a proof. This is how you create the cinematic look with only a camcorder, without going over the top. This isn't even a HD camcorder, but I can still give it a look. Now, this is where I can use it. This is the first way to do it. I would not insist doing this all the time, because this can potentially take away your creativity. You can put cinematics in there. You can put bleach bypasses in there, which are alright. Then I can go into cinematic one, give it that look. Now, this is only to add the looks. I'm not going into that jazz yet. There's no colour. There's no playing with colour there. So we're going to go into video effects, colour correction. Now we're going to go to RGB colour corrector. You can also use three-way. I'm going to use three-way today because I've never actually used three-way. How bad am I? I've just never... Never used this. I've heard about this. I've watched videos on this. But I'm going to try and use it myself. So if you think I'm going crazy as well, then you'll know why. Because I've never used this before. No, I'm not going to do it like that. I'm going to use... Yeah, I get the point. Nah, I don't get the point. Right, I'm going to turn this to sort of greenish. Don't go to the top though. I'm trying to... No, I'm really ruining this. That looks okay. Now, you can also fiddle around with input levels. Now, I'm trying to give it a dark look. Nah. Now, that looks amazing. I've got to admit, I'm trying to give it a really dark look. And you know what? I've just sold it there. I've really just sold it. That's what it's trying to create, a sort of dark hybrid look. As if it's the nighttime in the sea or something. And that's basically what I just pulled off there. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this three-way pass. Three-way colour correct, and I'm going to paste it on the end and see how it works. That doesn't really work there. So if you have that issue and you want to paste it over, edit your input levels if it's not going to quite work. And then this tote looks like it's underwater. Okay, now I'm going to be crazy, but I'm not sure that's going to work. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's going to work, thankfully. I may be messing around with the wrong settings here, but I'm not the judge of that, am I? Whoa, that is bad. That just looks awful. That doesn't look that bad. It fits. I'm actually quite proud of that. I'm going to pull the output level slightly to give that eerie look. I'm going to turn the input down slightly. So yeah, that's what we got there. So if you just watch this. That's cool. I like that. That is pretty good. Now, it's still missing something, because there's nothing happening at the end of that clip. So, we're gonna turn dip to black on. Now, I'm also gonna improve that by extending this to 5 minutes. So we got this. Okay, so I hope this helps. I mean, in this video, I've basically showed you how you can take a camcorder footage and still make it a variable level of cinematic look that's usable. So yeah, I've showed you how to cut and place things, put anamorphics on correctly, and at the same time, get a cinematic look out of a camcorder. I hope this helps. It might be a bit misleading. This is my first tutorial. I'm not sure how it's going to end up. But I think it went alright. My next video is up to you people. I mean, it might not be. I mean, but there is an idea. I'm thinking about next video, if I do another video, if it does go successful, I'm going to maybe look into creating how to export films correctly in the best settings, and also a couple other stuff, including a very new option only in Creative Cloud users you know about, which is connecting up to After Effects, so you can be in Adobe Premiere collecting clips up, but then appear like edit them in After Effects live with the other connected to Adobe Premiere. It's pretty cool stuff. But for now, guys, that is me doing a wrap. So, yeah. We'll pick up next time, I think. I don't know. This is your choice. It's not mine. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. This is the Matty Cono channel doing a first ever tutorial. Thanks for watching.